Hello, this topic is on writing CSS, where to write CSS. There are three places where you can actually write CSS. You can write local inline styles that are inline with the selector in the HTML body. You can write global embedded styles that are grouped together in the head of the HTML page. And last but certainly not least, you can write linked external styles that are located outside of the HTML document in a separate CSS document. When you write local inline styles, you can add your CSS inline with the selector in the HTML body. You add your style attribute directly to the HTML tags. You can see in this example how the color red is being set with CSS added directly to an H1 tag. The H2 tag is given a padding of 5 pixels, and the paragraph is set to the font Verdana. Notice that this is directly in the tag itself, as opposed to being called from some external source. Inline CSS is more powerful than using HTML presentation tags, like the font tag, but it does not take full advantage of the power of CSS, since each inline style only affects the HTML selector it is written in a particular spot on the specific HTML page. Inline styles are good when you want to quickly add a style to a single element for only one instance. You add global embedded styles to the head of your HTML page. Again, it is not called from an external source, it's located right there on that specific page. When you add global styles, the syntax is the same as when you add external styles. You start with the selector, which is the H1 in this example, and then list the property and value, which in this example is the property color set to the value of red. Global styles are more powerful than inline styles because they are located in one place, in the head, instead of being located throughout the HTML body. Also, because they apply to the whole HTML page, they can eliminate code and create efficiency when making updates. For example, when H1 is set to red through global properties, all H1s on the page are made red. Versus if you were using inline styles and wanted to do the same thing, you would need to add inline code for each H1 on the page, which is a real pain. In addition to making updates faster and easier, compacting the CSS code into the head of the page also reduces download time for the user. Global styles can only affect elements on the HTML page they're listed on. But what, for example, if we wanted to change all of our H1 tags to be red across all the pages on our website, not just on one single page? Linked external styles are listed in a separate CSS text file. The HTML file links to the separate or external CSS file in the head of each HTML file. This allows all pages on your site to read the same CSS file for styles, which makes it easy if, for example, you wanted all H1s on your site to be red. The CSS in the external file is the same format as with global styles. The only difference is the styles are listed in a separate document. When you use an external style sheet, many pages can link to just one style sheet, and then if you make a change, like changing the color value for H1s from red to blue, all H1s across your site that link to that single style sheet will be updated to blue. Additionally, this removes the CSS code from the HTML, which makes the HTML much cleaner, with only semantic or meaningful code. It also reduces the download time across the site, since each HTML file is smaller without the CSS code in it, and most web browsers only download the external file for a site once. It's beautiful. It's magic. It's CSS.